Hello everyone. In the previous session, we discussed about counter. So types of counters and their advantages, disadvantages and applications. So we discussed asynchronous counter and synchronous counter and their difference. So both the counters are used in many applications. So now let us in this session discuss about something called modulus. So what do you mean by modulus of a counter? So that is what we are discussing. In today's session, you will be understanding how you find out the modulus of a counter, what is a modulus of a counter, and how I can get my desired value of count. And we'll be designing mod 3, mod 5, mod 6 as such decade counters, and we'll be understanding what is presettable counter. So finally, we'll be discussing about the HTL implementation of counter, how to write a Verilog code count. Verilog code for the particular counters. So let me first make you clear what is counter modulus. Till now we know what is a counter. The counter definition gives you the number of events, number of clock pulses that has to be counted, which gives the count of clock pulses, or it can be also termed as number of events that occur there is a specific amount of time. So we'll discuss what is a modulus. Something about mod. Mod represents number of states that the counter can go through. So for example, if I tell mod 10, so mod 10 represents 10 states, but the count starts from 0 to 9. So mod n, in general capital N, represents number of states. N minus 1 will be the count. So mod 10 gives the count 0 to 9. Similarly, how many flip-flops are required to design such kind of counter is decided by this mod number. So mod number I represent 2 power n, where small n represents number of flip-flops required to design this particular mod. For example, mod 2 counter will have 2 states. So it counts only 0 and 1. So how many flip-flops do you require for this? 2 power 1 is equal to 2. So n is equal to 1. So you require only single flip-flop to design mod 2 counter. Similarly, if I take up mod 4 counter, so mod 4 is nothing but it consists of 4 states and count is 0, 1, 2 and 3, that is n minus 1. So if I need to count this 0 to 3, I require 2 bits. If 2 bits means 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. So mod 4 should count from 0 to 3. So you require 2 bits means 2 flip-flops. Each bit, one flip-flop will hold a single bit. So I require, if it is a 2 bit, so I require 2 flip-flops in this counter design. So first I am going to decide how many number of flip-flops do you require in this counter design. Then I am going to decide what should be the final value of count, what should be my desired count. Suppose I take up mod 8 counter, for mod 8, 0 to 7, the count will be 0 to 7, but 8 states, we call it as 8 states. So 0 to 7 in the sense, it starts from, the count starts from 0, 0, 0, ends till 1, 1, 1. So for that 3 bit, we require 3 flip-flops. This is how we are going to decide number of flip-flops based on mod number. So whether it can be an up counter or a down counter, number of states and number of flip-flops remain same. Only the counting fashion differs. Either you can go for incrementing fashion or you can go for decrementing fashion of counting, but the number of states remain the same. So finally, I can conclude that mod represents number of states that the counter has to count the sequence or complete a cycle, 0 to 7 back to 0. So this cycle repeats. We call this as a modulus. So the mod number or mod counter can be constructed with a count, even number 2, 4, 8, 16, 2 power. It's a power of 2, so 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, so on. Suppose in case I need to design a counter, a mod counter, such a way that if the number is 3, 5 and 7 as such, then how I need to design this counter. So how to design a counter other than your a natural count to 4, 8, 16, 32. So for that we require a certain logic to convert this. We want to skip some of the states. So for we call it as modified count. A natural count is nothing but which is occurring in 2, 4, 8. Modified count in the sense I will design with respect to mod 5, mod 6 as such. Then I am modifying the particular count. So we call it as modified count. So how to determine this modified count? How many flip-flops do we require? For that, if I take up an example mod 7. So if I take up an example mod 7, I should take a count such that it should be greater than the desired count. So which is the nearest in the natural count? We have a mod numbers mod 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. So whenever I want desired count, modified count, what we call mod 7 design, I should take the nearest smallest count, that is mod 8. So for mod 7, I take the design of mod 8, and in that I am going to modify for the desired count. So that is in the design I am going to take the nearest value for mod 7 is mod 8. I should take a greater number, not the lesser number. So I should take the 7 for mod 7 design, the greater count is mod 8. Then I will choose mod 8. In this mod 8 I am going to modify for the desired count required. Then I am going to design for this. If I take mod 5, then the nearest number for this is, once again I should take a nearest number mod 5, I will take mod 4. So number of flip-flops required for mod 7 is 3. So for this also 3. Since the mod 5 count I want 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, it should stop. So I require 3 flip-flops in the sense the desired count for this will have 5 states, and for this the nearest count mod number is 8. So I am going to take for mod 5, mod 7 a mod 8 counter as a basic counter design with 3 flip-flops. In this I am going to make a design such a way that it should count only the required value of count. For example, mod 5, I should get only 0 to 5 using mod 8. But mod 8 gives 0 to 7. I should stop after 5 and it should repeat back to 0. That is what how I will construct a mod counter. Take example mod 3. So lowest natural count greater than 3 is 4. So for mod 3, so the lowest natural count greater than 3 is 4. So I will be using 4, mod 4. So in mod 4 I require 2 flip-flops, since in mod 4 we have 0, 1, 2, 3 states. So we have 4 states. So I require 2 flip-flops. So for the mod 3 design also I will be using 2 flip-flops. Coming to mod 6. So for mod 6, once again the nearest count for this should be greater than 6. So I will be using 8. The nearest one is 8. So once again for 8 we require 3 flip-flops. I will be constructing this mod 6 using 3 flip-flops. Mod 9. For mod 9, the natural count what we are going to take here is 16, which is the nearest value and it is less than this natural count. So mod 16 will have 16 states with requirement of 4 flip-flops. So I will be using 4 flip-flops for the design of mod 9. This is how I am going to design a different mod counter other than this natural count by deriving from the natural count. So let us take up an design of mod 3, how it is designed. Mod 3, as I discussed, requires two flip-flops and the count is 0, 1, 2 and it should stop there. It should not go to 1, 1. So 1, 1, the next state is, since 2 bits means there will be 4 combinations. So natural count, automatically after 1, 0, it returns back to 1, 1. I need to stop this because my desired count here is mod 3. So mod 3, I should stop after 2. So I should make Q1 and Q0 both 0. So mod 3 require 2 flip-flops and output of the flip-flops are Q0 and Q1. So Q0 is LSB, Q1 is MSB. So since both the flip-flops are connected through clock synchronously, we call it as synchronous mod 3 counter. And we have J and K, all the K's are tied together. Output of first flip-flop is connected to the input of second and Q1 bar of the second flip-flop complement is connected to the first. So when the natural count is taking place, when Q0 is 0, so the flip-flop is, your J will be 0 and K is Li, so you will be getting the output as 0, the count is 0. So flip-flop is reset, your output is 0. So when Q0 is 1 and Q1 is 0, this is fed back in the next clock pulse, this flip-flop will be set. So you can just see here, in the next clock pulse this flip-flop will be set because of this feedback connection. So since I have Q1 as 0, my Q complement will be 1, so that 1 is fed back in the next clock pulse, so J and K both are 1, it will toggle. So the previous state was 0, now it has changed to 1. Since whenever the J and K both are equal to 1, the output of the flip-flop toggles. That is how you are getting the change of state over here. Even Q0 has become 0. So my count will be 0, 1 represents 1 count, 1, 0 represents 2 count. So finally, you will be getting 3 states, that is 0, 1, 2. So we have 2 flip-flops, so I will be getting 3 counts. Since I am forcing this to skip 1, 1 by making it 0, 0. So as I discussed, so the first flip-flop will toggle since both are high, and the second flip-flop will be 0 since the input to the second flip-flop is low and high. Similarly, at the next clock transition, this A will toggle to 0 because J and K both will be I. When J and K both are I, the A output of the first flip-flop and output of the second flip-flop will toggle. So whenever my input of first flip-flop is 0 and 1, in the next transition, when J becomes low and I, so your first flip-flop is reset and the second flip-flop is also reset because J and K are 0. This is how we will get the progress of this transition for all 3 states advancing with each clock transition. So divide by 3 clock output is formed at 3 waveform at second flip-flop, since the period is equal to 3 times of that of the clock. So when I write the output, so I will get Q0, Q1 at the negative transition. If I take negative clock, either I can take negative clock or positive clock. First transition, this is 0, and the next transition 0, 1. Next transition, this is 1 and this is 0. The next transition, this is 0, 0, 1, 0, 1. In this transition, 2 clock pulses 0 and then 2 clock pulses 1. So the count will be 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and then it should not go back to 1, 1. So since in the normal stage, it will go back to 1, 1, I am forcing it to make 0. So this will be 0, 0. Since I am designing mod 3 using mod 4. So I am skipping this state by clearing both the outputs of flip-flops to 0 by making it reset. This is how I can forcibly reset that particular state where I should stop, and the count should begin once again back from the initial state. Mod 6 counter design. Mod 3 gives you 4 states, 0, 1, 2, 3. So I can design mod 6 by combining the output of the mod 3 can be given to another flip-flop, so that 3 bits can be arrived here. So output of first mod 3 will be 2 bits. If I connect the output of the second flip-flop to the third flip-flops, we'll get 3 flip-flops together for 3 bits. Since mod 6 counter requires 3 bits, so it requires 3 flip-flops. Already it is there in mod 3 design, 2 flip-flops. I need to connect externally only 1 flip-flop. So I connect the flip-flop, second flip-flop output to the output to the input of the third flip-flop. So finally I'll be having 3 flip-flops A, B, C. Mod 6 design, I should count from 0 to 5 back to 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is a normal count. 6, 7 will be skipped by forcibly making the last 2 bits. After 5, it will go to 6, that is 0, 1, 1. So A and B outputs are forcibly reset. Those flip-flops are reset after this clock pulse. So all the flip-flops do not change in this simultaneously with synchronism with clock. So I can't tell this is synchronous counter, since my output of first flip-flop, second flip-flop is connected to input of third. So I can term this as an asynchronous mod 6 counter, since I am designing this counter using mod 3. You can see this circuit of mod 5 counter. Mod 5 counter, the number of states here, 5 states. The count is 5 minus 1, that is 4. You will get count from 0 to 4. 4 back to 0, the count should repeat. So in this case, since it is 3 bit, I will be having 3 flip flops here. Each flip flop is connected through clock, and the J and K inputs are tied to logic 1, and output of the first flip-flop is connected as a clock input to the second. So this represents an asynchronous counter design. So clock is externally applied here. So here the output of second flip-flop and output of first flip-flop is connected to AND gate, and AND gate output is connected as input to the third flip-flop. If you can see here, after 4, the next count supposed to be is 1015. So I need to reset this 1. So already I have 100. In the next transition, I should make this 0 forcibly. Already B and A as 0. Only the C, the third flip-flop output, forcibly I should make it reset 0. So I'll consider this C output, that is complement of this, will be having 0, that is fed back to the first flip-flop. So the first flip-flop now will be holding 0. So now it is reset. So already B and A has got zeros. Now I am forcibly making the first flip-flop 0. So finally it starts from the initial state, that is 0 0 0. So mod 5 will have 3 outputs and a clock, and you can see the count stops after 4. I am forcibly making the 5th and 6th count not come into this sequence. So the sequence once again repeats 0 to 4 by using this feedback connection, forcing the flip-flop to 0. You can just see, whenever C is low, the flip-flop A resets, thus A changes from 1 to 0. When A goes from 1 to 0, the flip-flop B triggers and B changes from 0 to 1, since J input of flip-flop C is low. Similarly, flip-flop C is reset and C changes from 1 to 0. So here we do resetting operation. For mod 10 counter, we call it as decade counter because it has 10 states and we have the count from 0 to 9. So in this counter design, we'll be having 4 flip-flops. Since it is mod 10, we require mod 10 design. I'll be using 16 as a natural count. For mod 16, we require 4 flip-flops. In that, I'll be using only 0 to 9 states. The rest all will be reset or skipped. We have to skip those states. How to skip those states? Let us discuss now. So here we have 4 flip-flops. You can see the flip-flops are connected through clock and the outputs are also connected here, and the clear inputs are connected to the NAND gate, and additional decoding gates are used here in the design to skip the desired count and to get only the required value. So will be unwanted counts will be skipped or made it forcibly zero using this NAND gate. So let us see the truth table of this mod 10 decade counter truth table. In mod 10 decade counter, we have 4 flip-flops. So this represents natural count mod 16, that is 0 to 15 count, but my desired count here is mod 10, means it should be 0 to 9. The count should stop here. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So after that, this should repeat. So we have here A, B, C, D, the output of flip-flops. So in the normal fashion, the counter will be counting here till 9. After 9, I have to stop it forcibly. By anyhow, C, B and C are already L to 0. So I should make here A and D reset. So I should make forcibly this A and C, A and D 0. So I connect this A and D output of the first flip-flop and the last flip-flop are fed to NAND gate. This will be output of first and the last flip-flop. It is fed to the input of NAND gate, and this NAND gate is connected to clear input of flip-flops. So let us discuss what is a clear input, what is a preset input. Other than the clock input, we have additional inputs. We call it as asynchronous inputs, which is not dependent on clock. So these inputs are preset and clear. This preset and clear are irrespective of clock. Whenever I want to set the particular count, I will be using this preset input. Whenever I need to reset or clear the flip-flop at any time, I can give this input to the flip-flop. Irrespective of clock, irrespective of the inputs, I can make or force the flip-flop to zeros or to the particular count. If I give preset as 1, my flip-flop will be set. If I give clear as 0, flip-flop will be reset. So this is how, irrespective of clock, I can stop or I can set to any value by giving these inputs. We call it as asynchronous inputs, which is independent of your inputs J and K or clock. So I am forcibly making this two ones, that is the output of first and the last flip-flop LSB and MSB, since the 9 will be my maximum count. After that you should repeat back to 0. The count starts from 0, stops till 9, then back to 0. To make this 0 forcibly, these two ones has to be made 0. How do I do that? Since the two inputs are there, I am sending this through NAND gate. So both one output of NAND gate will be 0. So this 0 is fed to the input of all the flip-flops, clear input of the flip-flop. So which forcibly stops the flip-flop, the previous transition, whatever it has been cleared. So all the flip-flops now will be holding 0. After this it will become 0 0 0 0, and this cycle repeats in the next clock transition. So then counter starts in normal fashion. So this is how mod 10 decade counter is designed. Similarly, I can design for any count, mod 6, mod 7, mod 5. By skipping those states, I can use this decoding logic, I can use this NAND gate to force it to 0. So we have another concept called resettable counter. As I discuss, we have another inputs other than your J, K and clock, asynchronous inputs, that is preset and clear. Anytime I can make or I can set the counter to my desired value. So presettable means the counters can be preset at any desired starting count. I can make my counter count from 3, 4, 5 like that, or I can make the counter to start from 5, 6, 7 as such. So to do this, we need additional circuitry, a logic such that I'll be loading inside the flip-flop required or desired count that has to be started, preset. So for that we use an additional logic here. In the circuit you can see 3 flip-flops are there. To this flip-flops we have additional inputs, asynchronous inputs, preset and clear. This bubble represents active low. These are all active low signals. It is not an inverter here. We represent an active low signal as bubble. So input to this flip-flops, we have a parallel load input, we call it as PL, which is an active low. Whenever I want to preset the particular count, I will send this through this, I will make this signal I input to the NAND gate here over here, as all one of the input to NAND gates of all the 3 flip-flops are tied and it is connected to preset load. So what is this preset load? It is a control signal to load the particular value. So whenever I am sending this signal, this will be active I, then I can load the data from here. For example, I want the count to be start from 5. So I will be loading here 1 0 1, and I'll make this also 1 by giving the signal logic 0 here. This is active low signal, so here I'll get 1, 1 and 1, output of NAND gate is 0. So I'm presetting here by giving the signal active low signal. My first flip-flop is loaded with 1 now. Similarly, I'm loading 0 here, 1 0 1 represents 5, the count 5. So now I am loading the count, desired count, that is 5. I should make this flip-flop to count from 5. So I am giving 0 here, similarly 1 here. So once it is loaded, then this control signal is removed. Next transition, I apply clock here. So with respect to this clock transition, J and K are tied to logic 1. So according to this output of the flip-flops, this starts set or reset based on the previous flip-flop. Now the count starts with 5. In the next transition this will become 1, because the output of the first flip-flop will be logic 1 since the flip-flop is set here. Similarly, the count starts unless until I clear it externally by making forcing this clear as 0. So this is what presettable count is. I can make the counter to count not from zeros other than zeros, I can count it in any fashion, either from 4 or from 5 back to 0. So this is nothing but resettable counter. Let us discuss now the same the counter design what we discussed till now about asynchronous counter and resettable counter, up down counter. What we discussed from the previous session and today's session, we'll be writing the same using Verilog code. So how to write a Verilog code for mod 8 up counter? I'll be declaring the variable, the file name as up counter, and it is enclosed with port list. Port list is nothing but the number of the inputs and outputs, whatever you are assigning or declaring is given inside this bracket that represents port list. Clock is an input, reset is an input, Q is output. So we have the input clock and reset. Since it is mod 8 counter, it requires 3 flip-flops, 3 bits. So 2 colon 0 represents, 2 1 0 represents 3 bit with output Q, and then I'll be using the statement always at with respect to this your output will respond. With respect to negative edge, or I can use also positive edge. So positive edge clock, the output triggers at the transition of positive edge. In case of negative edge clock, the output changes its state with respect to negative edge of the clock, or negative edge reset. So I'll be using two conditions inside this always at. These two conditions, either this or this. When clock is at the negative transition and when reset is there, if the operator not operator, if there is reset, then the entire three flip-flops will be clear to zero. So my output will be 3 tick B 0. 3 represents 3 bit, tick is an symbol or terminology used to represent binary. 3 tick B represents binary 0. All the three flip-flops will be stored with 3 zeros if my reset is 0. The operator here is not operator. Else, if reset is I, then Q starts incrementing. So if the Q was storing 0, 0, now it starts incrementing 1, 2, 3 as such till 7 back to 0. Q is equal to Q plus 1. Since I am using 3 bit, it will count maximum up to 7. So 0 to 7, you will get the count. So this is what the Verilog code for mod 8 up counter. Similarly, I can write the same code for down counter. Only the changes what I should make over here is minus. So Q plus 1, Q minus 1 represents down counting. The other method of writing code for mod 8 up counter with respect to the output of flip-flop, I can write by assigning the flip-flop inputs. So you can just see in the port list, I will be using here A and B, clock and reset. So clock and reset are the inputs and outputs are flip-flop outputs, that is A and B. So I have taken here the inputs, the wired inputs, it is nothing but intermediate inputs. What I do, the connection JA, JB, this is the inputs of two flip-flops, JA, KA, JB, KB. Then I'll assign the first flip-flop as input as NOT of B. So what is NOT of B? B is nothing but the output of second flip-flop, that is complement of second flip-flop is fed as a input to the first flip-flop. This is a feedback connection. Assign KA as 1 tick B 1. This represents logic 1. I am connecting K to logic 1 and connecting JA to the last flip-flop complement. And assign the output of the first flip-flop is connected to the input of second. So that's why JB is a input of second flip-flop, which is equal to output of first flip-flop, that is A. Similarly, I'll assign for KB 1. So KA and KB is tied to logic 1 and JA is the complement of second flip-flop, and JB is the output of first flip-flop. Finally, I declare with respect to a keyword JK flip-flop, JK1, the first flip-flop, with the output as A, JA, KA input, clock, reset, followed by A is an output, followed by all this inputs. JA, KA, clock, reset are inputs and A is output. So, here one flip-flop is being designed here, JK, FF, JK1 with the name JK1. So, JK flip-flop, JK2 represent the second flip-flop name, that is JK2, followed by the output and then inputs. So, two flip-flops are built here. This is what the Verilog code for mod 8 up counter using JK flip-flop. So, the outputs are already assigned in terms of inputs over here. Another method of writing the Verilog code for mod 8 up counter, you can just see here, Q represents output, JK represents input, and we have clock and reset as input. I'll be using reg as a temporary variable. Note here, always reg should be declared after output, not before output. If you declare reg before output, you'll be getting error there. So always the reg has to be assigned after output declaration, always at either with respect to negative edge clock or with respect to negative edge reset. If the reset is zero, this operator not operator, then my output is clear to zero. Else my Q is assigned with this operator less than equal to, since I need to force all outputs, I should not make only single output. That's the reason we are using this parameter less than equal to J and Q bar, Q complement or K complement and Q complement. So this was the equation what we derived in characteristic in previous session. Those characteristic equation is represented in terms of Verilog code. So let us discuss now how to write a Verilog code for up down counter. As I discussed in the previous session, we require an extra logic circuitry to load the counter either in upward fashion or downward fashion the count should occur. So to count in upward direction, I use a input control input, that is mode. So whenever the mode signal is 0, it counts in upward direction, and if it is 1, it counts in downward direction. That is what we discussed in the previous session, up down counter. So we need to load the data or the count parallelly. So when PL is equal to 1, parallel PL represents parallel load facility. When PL is equal to 1, a 3-bit number is loaded, asynchronously loaded to the counter. Asynchronous, note here, asynchronous means I am so loading this through preset signal. The counter counts at the negative of clock and its output is represented by Q. So for that, I am writing a code for up down counter. So module up down counter, the name of this file, you can give any name over here, but it should not be the keyword. So the clock is an input and this parallel load is an input, mode is an input, and D flip-flop we are using here, the design of up down counter, and Q is the output. So this is the data declaration. In the input side you have clock, then parallel load, then mode. So input, since 3 bits 2:0 D, and output is also 3 bits 2:Q. For mod 8 you require 3 flip-flops, so that's why 2:0. So as I said, you need to declare a reg after output, since it is a temporary variable which is holding your data. So 2:0 Q. We are using another variable called integer up down. So up down will be plus 1 or minus 1. It can increment or decrement depending on this mode selection. So it check the status of mode. Based on that, either it will be plus 1 incrementing or minus 1 decrementing. So it starts with begin. I am using the condition here if, so I should start with begin if mode. So based on the mode condition, up down will be is equal to minus 1. So minus 1 represents for down counting. Whenever there is a mode selected to 1, then it is in down counting operation. Then else up down is equal to 1. Mode 1 down counting, mode 0 it's up counting. If PL, now suppose I want to load particular count, then I should invoke this variable, that is PL. If PL, if parallel load is equal to 1, then my output follows the input, whichever is has to be sent to the flip flop will be sent at the output side. Else Q plus up down. Otherwise, the last L statement responds to the clock and the previous statement it starts counting. So this is how we are writing a code for both up and down using the control signals. I can also design this mod counter using an IC 74293. So in this IC we have outputs MR1, MR2, it is nothing but master reset, two reset pins, and we have two clocks here, two clocks CP1 and CP0. We have four outputs Q0, Q1, Q2 and Q3, and we have ground and VCC connection. So this is a IC which can be used to design any particular mod I can use or I can design for the using this IC. So in this IC, how do I make connection, how do I do the designing? So the question here is show how 74293 should be connected to prepare operate as mod 16 counter with 10 kilohertz clock input. Determine the frequency at Q3. So now I need to operate this IC to count till mod to count mod 16, that is 0 to 15, 16 states it has to count. So with the clock input as 10 kilohertz, so we have clock input connected, we have two clocks here. So usually the first clock is, that is CP0, is given with external clock, and the second clock is fed as the input to the first flip flop. Why? Because this is the external clock applied to this IC. The internal flip flops Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3, always the input to the first flip flop should be of clock. So this clock is given to the input of first flip flop. So that's the reason this feedback is given, which is connected to the first flip flop. So in turn, the output is of this is connected internally to the input clock of second and third and fourth as such. So now the external clock is applied to this IC through CP0, that is 10 kilohertz, and let us see, for mod 16 the count should start from 0 to 15, after that it should go back to 0. So the last one, that is Q3, what you are getting here is, it's a normal count, you will be getting 0 to 15. At the end you take the output at Q3, you will get F is equal to, the frequency here is equal to the input frequency divided by number of clock cycles required to for the desired count, that is mod 16. 10 kilohertz divided by 16, you will get the output side at Q3, the frequency is of 625 hertz. The input frequency is of 10 kilohertz, which has been divided with number of pulses, number of events that has occurred. So that is why it is 625 hertz, it is being divided. So this is how I can get determine the frequency of the flip-flop. How I can connect the same 74293 to design as mod 10 counter? As I discussed previously, mod 10, it is It has to count from 0 to 9, and explicitly I should make or I should reset forcibly back to 0. So that's the reason after 9 it is 1010. This 1010 I should make it forcibly 0. So that's the reason Q3 and Q1 both are connected to master reset. It is nothing but clearing those logic ones. So once it completes 1001, then I should stop 0 to 9. After that it should not go to 10, I should make it 0. So 10 is nothing but 1010. This 1 is nothing but Q3 output, 0, 1, the another one is nothing but Q1 output. Both the ones are connected to the master reset of this IC. So automatically it resets. Finally your output of this will be 0000. In previous case what we discussed using NAND gate, we have forced it to 0. The state will be forced to 0. So in this case there is an option in this IC resetting. So we have two options, reset 1, reset 2. We'll be connecting those bits which are logic 1 and making it to logic 0 by connecting this. So output, if I take from Q3, since it is mod 10, so 10 kilohertz is the input, so my output will be of 1 kilohertz. It divides the input frequency by 10 because mod 10, 10 clock pulses it has been taken to complete this operation. So output frequency will be of 1 kilohertz. Similarly, I can design the same using 74293, I can design mod 60 counter by cascading these two. So I'll cascade mod 10 using the same IC, I'll design for mod 10, and the second IC I'll design for mod 6. Mod 10, as you know, will be reset here, Q3 and Q1, MR1 and MR2. For mod 6 it should be 0 to 5. I'll be forcing 0110 to I have to skip the state, 6th state, 0 to 5, that is 0110. So I will be giving this to master reset. Then this particular IC will give you mod 6 count and the second IC will give mod 10. If I cascade output of this to the input clock of the second, so I will be cascading these two ICs to generate mod 60 counter. So output of the first IC is connected as input of clock input of second. Why? Because it is connected asynchronous. Since it is asynchronous counter, I need to connect the output of the last previous state to the input clock of the next state. That's the reason I have connected here. You can just see the external clock is applied to the first IC, not for the second IC. So the clock here over is nothing but the output of first. So this will serve as a clock to the second IC. Finally, I'll be getting the output over here Q3 from second IC, which divides by 60. This is mod 60 counter. So to conclude, till now I discussed about sequential circuits, how it is different from combinational circuits, and how the sequential circuits are designed. Under sequential, we have discussed registers, types of register, applications of registers. Under sequential, we discussed counters, types of counters, applications of counters, the counter design, modulus. We discussed something about modulus count, mod count, how to design a particular mod count. We also discussed up-down counter. We also discussed presettable counter, decade counter, as such. Can build many counters on the primary basic design. So by this I conclude, counters of any modulus can be constructed by incorporating logic which causes certain states to be skipped. Thank you.